There's no greater fright during a full moon than the blood-curdling howl of a wicked werewolf. But are they real? Or are werewolves just another mythical creature we made up?
Let's find out on today's episode of...
Colossal Question.
In folklore, stories, and present-day movies, werewolves are humans with the special ability to shapeshift into a wolf, or a human-wolf hybrid creature in more modern tellings. Also called a lycanthrope, werewolves are strong, bloodthirsty brutes with an unending desire to kill animals and people with wild, wolf-like instincts. Some people supposedly became infected by a curse, usually a bite or scratch from a werewolf, which gave them their shape-shifting powers. Others were said to use an enchanted sash or a cloak made of wolf pelt to make their transformation. Usually, it only happens in the light of a full moon. The earliest known example of a historical reference to werewolves comes in one of the oldest pieces of writing that still survives today, the Epic of Gilgamesh. In the tale, a woman turns her ex into a wolf. But that's just the first known example. It's super likely that other werewolf tales predated the Epic of Gilgamesh. But even if this just so happened to be the very first one ever, it's clear that werewolves have been a part of folklore for a long time. Okay, so we know the folklore is old, but what's the deal? If werewolves aren't real, where did all these stories come from? Could there possibly be any truth to the monstrous myth? Well, it turns out there might actually be some scientific and medical explanations for our werewolf fears. There are many medical conditions recognized in the modern world that might make someone seem wolf-like. Hypertrichosis is a rare condition that causes hair to grow all over the body. For some, the extra hair just grows in certain spots, but for others, it can cause the whole body to be covered in hair. Look familiar? Another possible culprit is lycanthropy, a mental disorder that causes people to believe they're a wolf or some other non-human animal. It's easy to see why people might have misunderstood these diseases in the past and assume the sick person was some kind of beast rather than plagued by a disorder. So, are werewolves real? Nope. But our fascination with them seems like it's here to stay.